Wonders like ourselves. We don't follow a script and we don't rehearse. Ah, and I don't know what tonight's performance will be. In this hat are 13 pieces of paper upon which character names have been written. I.S.M. Tonight, my dears, you will be playing Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah!
And which part will you play?
Tree number one,
drzewo numer dwa.
Dude, this has got to be rigid. I'm always friggin' tree.
Weź nic mi nie mów. W tramwaju z onym pożądaniem grałam latarnię.
Now, there is no such thing as a small role. Actors, in your places. And listen. Romeo and Juliet, the greatest love story of all time, takes place over 6 days. That's right. Romeo and Juliet fall in love, marry, and die, all within 6 days of meeting each other. Are you up for the challenge?
Yay!
That's what I want to hear. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I bring you Romeo and Juliet, 6 very busy days. Our play begins on a Sunday in their marketplace in Verona, Italy. Servants from the Capulet family run into servants from the Monte family. The Capulet just can't help but pick a fight.
Kolejny dzień na ulicach Werony. Duszno, gorąco, a ja złotałbym jakiegoś Montekiego.
Wiadomo, ja też. Hej, patrz, tam, widzisz? To Monteki.
Jak ja ich nienawidzę. Wykrzyw się na nim.
Wykrzyw się,
zaufaj mi.
Mogę rzucić ci piosenkę albo pokazać coś?
Wyszyw się!
Okej. La 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 la.
Hey, check it out.
Do you bite your papadaser?
Mówiłem! Hey, she asked you a question. Do you bite your papadaser?
Tak, skrzywił się. But don't you bite his papadaser?
Nie pani, nie skrzywiłem, ale robię to.
Do you make spastic ninja kicks at mister?
Nani!
And what's with them all?
go. I've got one word for you, pal.
Next.
Move on, forget about her.
Oh, teach me how I should forget.
I tell you what. The Capulets are having a huge party tonight. Let's, you and me, crash the party and then you'll see Rosalind surrounded by all the beauties of Verona. And then you'll see that she's not all that.
I will go, but only to prove there is no one more beautiful than my Rosalind.
I'll be the one.
Now, remember, we can't tell anyone. Our families hitch over. They never approve.
Yeah, that whole ancient grudge thing. So, it's tomorrow then.
Good night.
Romeo and Juliet enlist the help of Juliet's nurse and friar Lawrence to help pull off their secret wedding.
Now, the nurse isn't really a nurse in the sense that we think of nurses today. She's what we'd call a nanny. And the friar is a priest, not a chicken. Got it? Good.
Remember, the only other person at their wedding is Romeo's manservant, Balthazar. Where is Balthazar? Well, it appears that we don't have Balthazar.
I'm Balthazar!
This is it! The prank I've been waiting for!
Okay, you're Balthazar. Our story picks up the wedding of Romeo and Juliet.
And do you, Juliet, do you take Romeo to be your husband?
Yes, I do. I love everything about him. His broad shoulders, beautiful smile, and gorgeous blue eyes.
And good brown eyes, Rosalie.
Juliet!
Juliet, sorry.
You guys have issues.
Shut up!
I'm just saying.
Now I pronounce you man and wife.
Little does Romeo know that Juliet's cousin Sibold is looking for him. He still thinks that Romeo crashed the couple's party.
Co widzę? Mercutio! Gdzie ten gaz? Chodzący proszony na imprezy koleżka Romeo?
What do you want with Romeo? You're not going to hurt him, are you? I couldn't let anyone touch my friend, Romeo.
Here we go again. Okay, dziękuję za to wyjaśnienie, Mercutio.
Tu jesteś! Romeo! Ty uciekłeś!
I'm going to pretend that you didn't say that, Tybalt.
Lovely day, isn't it? It's a bit cloudy, but it makes me later of the day.
Please, but...
I'm coming, Mercutio. And enough gossiping people.
Ale to jeszcze jedna kwestia. Jesteśmy obywatelami. Może nie mamy dużych rzeczy z królem, ale jednak jesteśmy bardzo ważni do tego przedstawienia. Nie
mamy królu! Yeah, you keep telling yourself that. And we come back to Gaffin.
Romeo! Obrona mojego kabinetu! Nadszedł czas zapłaty!
Oh, baby time!
Baby for what exactly?
Co to znaczy?
Me! Daddy! Me!
Why don't you just get along?
Yeah.
someone. Edward did or he didn't. Did you kill him or not?
Yeah, I killed him.
And are you banished from Verona?
Yeah.
That's not good. How much time we have together?
Till the sun comes up.
And are you gone forever?
Yeah.
Moja pani, nadchodzi twoja matka. Jest tutaj twoja piękna, niewinna młoda córka, która ciągle opakuje śmierć swojego ukochanego kuzyna Tybalta. Moja biedna córko, wyglądasz okropnie. Ciężko znosisz śmierć Tybalta. Widać, że bardzo go kochałaś.
Tybalt.
No nie płacz już. Wymyśliliśmy z ojcem lekarstwo na twój smutek. Poślubi mi z Paryża!
Co?
Skarb jest prawdziwy mężczyzna. Przystojny, bogaty, taki bogaty. Pół miliona należy do niego.
Mato!
Pochodzi z dobrej rodziny szlacheckiej.
Mato, nie poślubi mi Paryża!
Oczywiście, że poślubić. Ma wszystko, czego mogę chcieć. Znaczy, czego ty możesz chcieć. On też wydaje się być zadowolony, gdy patrzy na ciebie. Czeka na ciebie za drzwiami.
Mato!
Paryżu, proszę wejść.
Zagwozdka.
Ojcze, przysięgam, że się zabijesz i zmuszą mnie do ślubu.
Spokojnie, Julio. Jeśli jest aż tak źle, to wydaje mi się, że mam plan, który może zadziałać.
Wszystko, tylko nie ten ślub z Paryżem. Mogę w nocy wyjść na gościeniec, gdzie grasują zbójnicy, wstąpić do groty pełnej żmii, spędzić noc w kosmicie wśród szkieletów.
Szkieletów mówisz? Masz tutaj miksturę, uśpicie na 48 godzin. Wszyscy będą myśleć, że umarłeś. Odprawię pogrzeb i pochowam cię w rodzinnym grobowcu. Napiszę list do Romea, w którym poinformuję go o naszym podstępie. Będzie na ciebie czekał w grobowcu, kiedy się obudzisz.
Daj mi tę miksturę, proszę!
Wypij ją dziś przed zaśnięciem. Napiszę list do Romea, zaniesie go brat Jan. Janie, podejdź! Chyba nie mamy Jana.
Ja!
That night, before going to bed, Juliet drinks the potion.
Dobre?
Dobre.
Nic się nie dzieje.
Wednesday, and Juliet's nurse goes to wake her up. Wstawać, moja pani! Zbudź się! Nie żyje! Moja pani nie żyje! Co to za hałas? Nie żyje, Julia, nie żyje! Co za bzdury, spokój się, to niemożliwe!
Balthazar, the only person besides the friar and dinners who knows about Romeo and Juliet's secret marriage, stumbles onto Juliet's funeral.
Oh no! I must run to Mount to what has sent my lord Romeo! His beloved Juliet is dead!
It is Thursday. Now we all know she isn't dead, but Romeo doesn't. He never gets friar Lawrence's letter.
Sorry.
This means that Romeo knows nothing about the sleeping potion. It's up to Balthazar to gently break this news to Romeo.
News from Verona! How now, Tree? I mean Balthazar, do you have any letters from Friar?
She's dead! Juliet is dead!
Romeo runs to an apothecary's shop. An apothecary is kind of like a pharmacist, but not only does this apothecary sell medicine, he sells poison too, and that's illegal in Verona.
Let me get this straight. You want me to break the law and sell you a potion?
I need that potion!
Let me guess. You have some rats to extermine, right?
Maybe I do. What's it to you?
I believe I have just what you need to get rid of those pesky rats.
I thought so.
One drop of this is enough to kill 20 men, rats.
It is Friday. Romeo takes his deadly purchase and under the veil of early morning darkness sneaks into Verona.
Ani kropli nie pozostawił dla mnie.
Nic.
Sztylet mi pomoże, niech rdzewieje od krwi.
It's so sad.
A na początku było zabawnie.
What did he have to die?
Because it's a tragedy, of course. And what few people realize, especially those who have never read the play, but only seen one of many movie adaptations, is that Romeo and Juliet are not the only ones who die at the end of the play. Paris dies also.
Paris? How?
Romeo kills him. You see, in the actual play, Paris is there outside Juliet's song when Romeo arrives. Paris thinks that Romeo is there to discredit Juliet's final resting place, so he attacks Romeo, and Romeo kills him. I know, it makes him a bit less sympathetic, doesn't it? And Romeo's mother dies too.
Yeah.
She dies of a broken heart when Romeo is banished from Verona.